Today, I want to teach you how to generate random numbers and also how to pick a random item from a list. So that one is not exactly going to be a random number, but it's kind of related. If you want to support this channel, please leave a like and comment. Just being more active goes a long way. So in order to generate a random number in Google Sheets, there are three functions. One of them is called rand, like this. And what this is going to do, it's going to generate a random number between 0 and 1, and 1 not included. So basically between 0 and 0.99999. And then there is another function, that one is rand between. This is more for generating a whole number. And for this one, you give it a low and a high, and it's gonna generate a number between those numbers. So for example, if I do 1 and 10, this is gonna generate a random number between 1 and 10. As you change something in a spreadsheet, those random numbers are gonna update and it's gonna generate a new number. So you can obviously change this to any number you want as the low and high. So if you wanted to generate, let's say, a random 5-digit number, then you would start something like 10,000 up to 99,000. So basically the first number in that 5-digit number list and the last number. And that should give us a random 5-digit number. And then finally, the third function here is rand array. And this generates a random array. This is very similar to this function, this first rand function. The only difference is instead of generating just one, it's gonna generate an array of numbers. So here you have rows and columns. So if I type 2, for example, for rows, and columns are optional here. So if I close parentheses and hit enter, see, generates 2 rows of random numbers. I can go here and do a comma and do 4 columns, so 2 rows, 4 columns, and that's gonna generate an array of random numbers, basically an array of this in this whole area. So if you wanted an array, you could use this rand array instead of just regular rand function. So if you're trying to get a whole number, this rand between is your friend. If you're trying to get a number that has certain decimal points, you could actually combine this with this. So I could just take this that generates a random number, and then I could add that rand function to generate something with decimal points. And if you wanted this to be a certain number of decimal points here instead of any number of decimal points, you could just go here and add round to this. And then provide decimal places. So if I do 2 decimal places, that's gonna be 2 decimal place right here after this. If you wanted 4 decimal places, you can round to 4. That is actually doing 4. This is just now not formatted correctly. So let's actually add a few decimal points. So there you go. As you change your data, that should update as usual. Now, the next thing I wanna go over is this random array example. So this random array gives you this decimal point number in array format. But what if you wanted to have a whole number in this array? Now there is no rand array like that rand between to basically give you an array of integers. So what you can do instead, you can just take this, which gives you a number between 0 and 1, multiply it by a number. So for example, if I do 10, and here to make sure this works, I'm gonna do Command Shift Enter or Control Shift Enter to do array formula. I'm gonna hit enter, and you're gonna see that what's gonna happen here, we generate basically a number between 0 and 9.99, right? Basically, we just move the decimal point by multiplying that whole thing by 10. What I can do now, I can take this number, if I didn't want this decimal points and all of that, I can just take that and do something like int to remove decimal points, to use int function, integer. So what this is gonna do, it's basically just gonna now give us a number between 0 and 9, because what's going to happen is, see, we get a 0, but we're never gonna reach 10, because even if it's 9.9999, it's gonna trim the rest and we're gonna get to 9. Now, if your intention was to generate a random number between, let's say, 1 to 10, this gives me 0 to 9. So I can just go here, do plus 1. And this should now generate a number between 1 to 10. And if I wanted to get a number, let's say, between 1 and 100, I would just multiply this by 100, or really any number, like you could do 50. So now it would be a number between 1 and 50. And then finally, let's go over a case of selecting something from a list. So let's say we have a random list, and we'd like to pick one of these names in a list randomly. So the way we can do that is by creating a rand between function. And I'm gonna just provide 1 as a starting point, comma, and then however many items I have here. So in this case, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So I'm gonna do 5. So this is gonna give me a random number between 1 and 5. Now, if I wanted this to just select a name from this instead of just giving me 1 to 5, I can just put this inside of index function. And in index function, I'm gonna highlight this range of names, comma, and then we can just, as an index, provide that random position between 1 and 5. And if I hit enter, see, that gives me Kate. So that should be your random item from a list. So if you wanted to do something like that, you can. And if you didn't want this to be a range from a spreadsheet, you could also just hard code this in an array like this. Anna, Joe, and basically just comma separate this list. I'm just gonna do 3 this time and just change this between 1 and 3. And that would be a random item from this list of 3. Now I don't have to have this over here. And that should do it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.